Hello, YouTube. Steve here from KDog Graphics. I'm back with another video. And this will be a quick one today. Because, well, I'll admit, when I was working on this stuff, kind of plan, I know, I got very frustrated and decided that it wasn't big. I had to figure out how to get this working. So, what you're seeing here is the character's robe. I've had a lot of time working on trying to figure out a way to get the clothing pattern working. We're going to cover the creation of the boots. Also work on the gloves as well, which I'm pretty proud of. A lot of the detail is really great on this. So I'm going to go over and do a quick overview of how I worked on the character's robes. I will admit this was very frustrating to figure out how to get it looking. Look in a certain way, and decide to have any textures get that going. So I'm going to jump into Motion Designer, and I'm going to show you how I create my pattern in the Substance here. Second. And for those of you who are not familiar with this program, the non-linear texture system is really powerful. I love this program, and I couldn't live without it. Anyway, so for the embroidery pattern, I chose to go with a clock. This character perfectly. There's a time traveler, and I wanted him to feel like he's a traveler. So with this, I began with this image right here that I created in Photoshop. And I kind of wish I did it in Illustrator. See if I could take the detail. And I also kind of wish, too, that this is painted supported on SVG files. That'd be pretty nice to have. So for the first thing I did was I created the transform node and shrunk down the clock to a certain size. And I kept it in the middle of the document so that we can work out the other details. Okay? You might notice I'm using the same source image as the rest of the down a little bit. It's a great thing about this program, Substance Designer. It's actually very non-destructive, and basically everything in this graph is run from a single image. So I also went ahead and created transforms for each piece of the texture. And I kind of wish that I hope that version 6 for the patches as well, we'll have just to save some speed. Unfortunately, one of the drawbacks of Designer, it's it can be very, very heavy at 4K. There we go. So I created a transform node, and I put the image in the corner. I kind of wish that this version of Subject Designer had a transform node to snap the boundary, so that I could snap the center of any image that I transform into any of the edge boundaries. I'm sure they have it working out. This program is really good for a lot of nonlinear texture editing. I did the same thing here. So that was the next four images in the corner. And after I do each one, I blend them together. I set the mode to max lighten, which will take all the bright pixels, put them together to put them together while maintaining the black background we have. I finally finished with them here. Another blend node, max lighten, and it's all the textures fine with it. And same thing with smaller clocks. This was a little easier to fix. I'm hoping that in the future to have a version of the transform node that will allow snapping into document boundaries. Now, I didn't use a safe transform node because I couldn't get it like this. I wouldn't be able to scale it down when I wanted it to. When I was finished, right over here, so Glenode, put it all together. In the testing, I plugged all this into a tile generator just to see how it would look when it's tiled. And I was very impressed with this when I got it all tiled and everything. Took a little number. There we go. And then once it's finished, once it's done, I did an export. And what you see on the jacket is the same texture here. Now I'll close this iron. Now. And then now I'm gonna go ahead now and show you how I applied image texture to the sash of the envelope. So to do this, I go to my I create a layer called Sash Embroidery. Then I go ahead and create a fill for this. And the fill will help us a lot when we're working on adding tile and sashes. Now, originally, I hand painted all this originally, and it looked great, but it was too time consuming for my taste. And I want something done quickly with this. So, go to my grayscale tool, grayscale option, and let's add a tile generator on top of this. And if you're familiar with a tile generator in Fortune Designer, it's the same exact thing. That's one designer. And I want the clocks on the sash, so the patterns, you hit image input. This is where you type in the texture you want, so I want my clock texture that I need. So now it's in there. And what I want to do now is I'm going to transform the pattern a little bit. I want to add like 18 by 18 tiles, which I think is really good for what we're going to do with this. But basically, that's pretty much it. There's nothing more you need to do. The clocks are all the same orientation. You know, that's the hard part about working like this. But what if you're tempted? Go ahead in there and edit the clock or change the rotation of the clocks. That's pretty easy to do. Go to paint, add a paint modifier in here, and then let's go to our alpha, and I'll pick the wash here. And basically what I want to do is I want to change the angle of one of these clocks. Actually, I can't do it that bad. So let's erase one of the clocks. That is one of the greatest things about I love working with. It's the fact that we can basically paint on top of this whatever we want. I'll go ahead and hit the X key to put my color. And when you're painting here, do not use the eraser tool. I made a mistake recently, and actually I had a pretty good laugh about that using the eraser tool. And let's erase it. Okay, you're not hurting anything. I apologize that this is a little bit slow here. This is what happens when you paint on a high resolution texture in space. It won't be as quick. A little time to catch up. And I'm on a laptop too, so it's not particularly quick. Alright, so that's enough there. So now I want to add clock with a different rotation mark. To do that, I'm going to go ahead and clock back on there. And I'm going to change the angle jitter to something different, like 72. And I'm going to try to mesh the size of the clock this way I can. Because I'm basically, of course, I was not going to come in here and like all of them like this, but you know, it's a lot of work involved. And now I was clicking the viewport. Yeah. Bear in mind that anything you do here will affect all channels. There's your clock right there in a different orientation. Do another one. Go ahead and click it again, and you see how the clock will rotate differently every time. Now, initially, I was going to come in here and do that with all the clocks. But, you know, it's time consuming, and, you know, it's Not worth the energy right now to reach go in there and chain all this stuff over. One other thing about Pinner that you might love most, I recommend you guys download the trial and see if you like it, is if I go ahead and hide this paint modifier, or operator, I don't know to call it, you'll see that the texture below is unaffected, which is great. You do not want that happening to your textures. So that's pretty much it. Nothing really more for me to show or to demonstrate here. So this is basically the finished costume for the entire character, except for the skin, which we're tackling in another video. So I hope you guys liked the series so far. I know it's a long series and there's a lot of detail in there. I really hope you enjoyed and learned a few things about you being such as designer and painter to create characters. And then in the next series, I will be working on the character's head, including skin and hair. Hair plans would not be recorded for real time. I'm going to have that time lapsed. Because hair placement is very tedious. Not many people like it. Has to be done. You'll probably notice as well that I skipped the shirt and the pants, since their details will be modified in Unity. Using a towel is good detail normally. But anyway, leave a like, if you like the video, it'll definitely motivate me to make some more. Definitely leave a comment below. Share your thoughts with me. Let me know what you think. Ask any question you want. I'll definitely answer. Plus, your interaction will definitely let me inspire me to keep doing more of these models for my series. So, without further ado, let's get Sheep saying, have a wonderful afternoon, happy arting, good day now.